9 o'clock news, which was to have followed, has been cancelled tonight so that we can bring you the quarterfinals of the All Essex Badminton Championship. Your commentator, as usual, is Edna O'Brien.
Hello, fans. Be garin' to be sure. There's some fine badminton down here in Essex this afternoon. We really...
soft-bodied, unsegmented invertebrate animal, usually protected by a large shell. One of the most numerous groups of invertebrates, it is exceeded in number of species only by the arthropods. Fizz.
Not very interesting, is it?
What?
I was talking to him!
Oh. Anyway, the typical mollusk, viz. A snail, consists of a prominent muscular portion, the head foot, a visceral mass and a shell which is secreted by the free edge of the mantle.
Dreadful, isn't it?
What?
I was talking to him!
Oh, well, anyway. In some mollusks, however, viz. Slugs, the shell is absent or rudimentary.
Switch him off.
Whereas in others, viz. Cephalopods, the head foot is greatly modified and forms tentacles, viz. The squid. What are you doing?
Switching you off!
Well, don't you like it?
Oh, it's dreadful!
Embarrassing!
Is it?
Yes, it's perfectly awful!
Disgraceful. I don't know how they got the nerve to put it on.
It's so boring!
Well, it's not much of a subject, is it? Be fair.
What do you think, it's yours?
Oh, give him another 20 seconds.
All right.
Anyway, the majority of mollusks are included in three large groups, the gastropods, the lamellibranchs, and the cephalopods.
We know that!
However, what is more interesting is the mollusk's sex life.
Oh!
Yes, the mollusk is a randy little fellow whose primitive brain scarcely strays from the subject of you-know-what.
Disgusting!
Ought not to be a lad.
The randiest of the gastropods is the limpet. This hot-blooded little beast with its tent-like shell is always on the job. Its extramarital activities are something startling. Frankly, I don't know how the female limpet finds the time to adhere to the rock face.
How am I doing?
Disgusting!
But more interesting.
Oh, yes!
Another loose-living gastropod is the periwinkle. This shameless little libertine with its characteristic ventral locomotion is not the Marian kind. Anywhere, anytime is its motto, up with a shell in their attic. I'm coming to them. The great scholar. This tatty, scrofulous old rapist is second in depravity only the common clown. This latter is a right whore, a harlot, a trolloper, cynical, bed-hopping, firm-breasted, Rabelaisian bit of seafood that makes Fanny Hill look like a dead pope. And finally, among the lamellibranch bivalves, that most depraved of the old subspecies, the whelk. The whelk is nothing but a homosexual of the worst kind. This gay boy of the gastropods, this queer crustacean, this mincing mollusk, this screaming, prancing, limp-wristed queen of the deep makes me sick.
Have you got one?
Yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll teach it. Well, thank you for a very interesting programme.
Oh, not at all. Thank you.
Yes, that was very nice.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Good night.